I think what we're in the business of is creating experiences for people. And I think the more variety there is and who's in the audience with you, the more fun the party is. So first out of the gate, Viet Gone by Quy Nguyen. It is really about him peeling away the layers of his parents' romance, how they got together. Hilarious, spicy language, and a window into how the Vietnamese themselves view America's role there that is completely counter to most of what I grew up with. So a very fresh voice in the American theater and a story that I think most of us are not familiar with. Oklahoma is my directorial debut in Denver. I couldn't be happier that it is something like Oklahoma that I think has a lot of entry ramps for a lot of different people, a lot of different tastes. And I'm particularly excited that it is an all-black cast telling this extraordinary American story. Because when you hear that group of people saying, "We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand," in the moment we're living in, that is an extraordinary sentiment to hear sung by that community. The music is totally ridiculously infectious. More dancing in this show than anything that we've done, except for maybe Molly Brown. It's hilarious, really witty. Upper-class British family, and the woman finds out early on that her mother and her sister are scandalized that her husband's having an affair with her best friend, and she's like, yeah, so. Totally fresh, unbelievably modern look at marriage, take on marriage with very, very clear eyes. What I love about it is that this very privileged woman learns about her own agency, her own ability to kind of tackle the world on her own, outside of that prescribed relationship. When I got to see this production last year, it was the best that I've ever seen, actually. I think this company has put together just a beautiful production of it. And clearly that has resonated and continues to resonate with audiences here. So I think it's a fantastic way to celebrate. One of the pieces I'm most excited about, Danetta Gray's play Last Night and the Night Before. We workshopped it in the Summit last year. Lesbian couple in Brooklyn. One of the partners grew up in the South. She got out of small town and they've created a successful life for themselves. One day, her sister and her sister's 10-year-old daughter show up on the doorstep in clear desperation. It's about families. It's about why one fate ends up going one way and one another. It's about what comprises a family today and how somebody, this young kid in very tricky, difficult circumstances, has and finds unbelievable emotional resilience. It's a beautiful play. Anna, a beautiful woman in a loveless marriage with enormous privilege in Russia in the 19th century, and she risks everything for love. She meets a handsome, dashing, young military officer, and there is, in this story, enormous price to be paid for that. That's set against, you know, the backdrop of aristocratic czarist Russia in the 19th century, which is an extraordinary moment in history. One of the things that I really love is bringing works of literature to a form where they can be shown on stage. And clearly it's been resonant here in Denver. And so Anna Karenina is a way to kind of celebrate that impulse, if you will. The Whistleblower is about a writer who has been very ambitious and gets to a moment where it feels like the things he has dreamed about for himself career-wise are handed to him. He's pitched this television show and the producer says, yes, let's do it. And at that moment, something happens to him. Call it a spiritual opening, call it a nervous breakdown, something goes funky. And he walks away, he turns away, you know, from that opportunity. And what becomes absolutely imperative for him in that moment is that he visit all of the primary relationships in his life because he realized there is a discord between his inner self, his authentic self, and how he's been living his life. And begins telling the truth. And the people around him think he's lost his mind. It's hilarious. It's really thought-provoking. It's really kind of a spiritual journey. Lynn Nottage won the Pulitzer, her first Pulitzer for Ruined. Sweat, she also won the Pulitzer for. She focused her sights for this project on working class America. She goes to Reading, Pennsylvania. There's a factory town and generations have made their living in the factories. Friends have, you know, grown up together and in a pretty interestingly racially integrated community. And as we all know, those factories are struggling and they're shedding jobs and they're sending jobs overseas. And that's happening to this town. And some people's fortunes rise and some people's fortunes fall. And the cost of that in terms of relationships is real and intense. It is a powerful drama and wonderfully drawn characters and a conversation that I'm really, really excited to share with this community.